maybe you'll start thinking it's also bizarre and wondering more about this issue. Now, the efficiency implications are the things that are important. I haven't said that they're important. I've just said all this stuff. Now, what are the implications for efficiency? And I'm a public finance economist. I'm interested in the terms that I'm interested in public business services, taxes, all sorts of things. Well, for me, if donors are actually, if these perceptions are correct, if donors are reluctant to pay for fixed costs, then, and if this is a situation that U.S. charities are actually faced with, then there are no guarantees that the most cost-effective charities are actually selected by donors to receive the donations. And what that means is that the sector is inefficient, because donors are contributing to charities that maybe aren't doing the best job. If they did contribute to charities that were doing a better job, then we could increase provision within the sector for the same amount of money. So there would be an efficiency enhancement. So this is if charities actually now, if U.S. charities respond to these concerns actually by even adopting inefficient strategies that avoid fixed costs, then we'll also see not only inefficiency because of donors choosing to give their money to their own charities, but we'll also see innovation slow down in the sector. These are the predictions of my model, my analytical framework. I generate these predictions, and now what I do is I try to find data to see if I'm right, or to look to the world and try to find evidence, to establish a causal relationship between the perception of donors about fixed costs and output in the sector. So I can't find that data anywhere, so I now resort to lab experiments. So both of these things imply inefficiency. Why do we care? All of this is just talk. I care because if there's inefficiencies, then there is an efficiency-based rationale for government intervention that's targeted towards fixed costs. Because the only rationale for an economist for government to intervene is on the grounds that government can correct inefficiencies in the marketplace or whatever, or for distributional reasons. Here we have the situation where my framework is telling me that this sort of special challenges in the nonprofit sector with respect to fixed costs can create inefficiencies, not only in terms of output in the sector, but also in terms of how quickly innovations happen. That means that there is a rationale for government to step in and intervene. What is the form of the intervention? Now, you might thank me, you might love me if I said the form is to fund fixed costs. It could be that. It could also be something other than that regulation. I don't know the answer to analyze that particular question. But this is not a problem that is innocuous, and it's not a problem that the sector should have to deal with on its own simply because there are clear inefficiencies associated with these. And that's something we don't see in the private sector at all. So it's a completely different story for the private sector. So there is an efficiency-based economic rationale for government intervention that's actually targeted towards fixed costs, and that's a corrective intervention. So it's an important question to answer because of those efficiency implications. This sector's big, there's a lot of money involved, there's a lot of provision involved, there are a lot of recipients of the provision who might be better off. So this research that I'm doing on this question is, I'm trying to understand this. I'm trying to understand, do donors have these weird perceptions? And if they do have these weird perceptions, how is it affecting efficiency in the sector and innovation in the sector? And why do the donors have these perceptions? What are the underlying mechanisms that are actually driving donor behavior? So my analytical findings, I've got a framework which is a mathematical model, which you would hate, I know, because it would just completely abstract from most things. But the findings are that the analysis of performance of the nonprofit sector requires actually a completely different economic toolkit than the ones we use when analyzing performance in the for-profit sector. We cannot just map things that we know about the for-profit sector into the nonprofit sector and expect everything to work the same but for nonprofits. There's a different toolkit, there's a different set of tools that we need. So we've got my hypothesis, we've got my analytical framework. What my preliminary lab results say about all of this is that donors actually do relate to fixed costs in a peculiar way. If you think they do, they actually do, right? And this has been, my evidence in the lab actually shows this. And that evidence is completely generalizable because it's actually, I'm using lab experiments to test the theory. this is that they think of provision that involves relatively large fixed costs as being more risky. And I've tested this in the lab, this behavioral concept. And my test shows that this is the perception that donors have. Now, one, you know, you might think, what does it mean? Well, if you think about a donor who has a choice of contributing to charity A, which is efficient and has large fixed costs, and charity B, if the fixed costs aren't covered in charity A, then there's a chance that the provision won't happen. When even if everybody in the world is better off contributing to this charity, if donors think that somebody makes a mistake and doesn't give the contribution to the right charity, then that makes it risky because then that charity might not be able to engage in the provision. So it doesn't have to do with fear of fixed costs. It has to do with fear of how other donors are going to behave. Donors fear that other donors might make mistakes and do the wrong thing. And that makes the output of the charity with the large fixed costs risky compared to the output of the charity with the small fixed costs. Now, in situations then, so that's point one, right? Donors do worry about it. They worry about it because they think of the high fixed cost option as a riskier prospect, even though it's not rational for them to do that. In situations where they're small in a lab, conducted experiments in situations where there are small groups of subjects having to choose between two options involving fixed costs. What we found is that a higher fixed cost option, the more efficient one, and donors knowing that it's more efficient and being able to see output of this one, output of that one, and so when I say payoff dominates, meaning everybody gets more and they're using more efficient technology, for the same money, provision is higher in the efficient option. A less efficient, lower fixed option, cost option is the other choice. What we find is that the efficient option, the one that people should choose 100% of the time if they're behaving rationally, is chosen only 63% of the time. This is an astonishing outcome. This is in the lab, where we have a controlled environment, where there are no incentives for the participants to do anything other than individually rational. But even in this situation, donors or subjects worry that the subjects that they're playing with will make mistakes. So this is actually really, you know, absolutely astonishing to me. I mean, it suggests that these fears about donors being afraid of its cost are probably accurate, but maybe it's not fear driving these other things. And if we know what the other things are, then you as charities can know how to respond to them in terms of your fundraising strategies. The evidence points to the choice of being driven by the behavior that I was mentioning. The fact that the donors or the subjects seem to think of the fixed cost, high fixed cost option as being riskier. And so that means they think of a world where they don't think that people are going to do the right thing or they're going to make mistakes. So there's poor coordination. So what subjects do is they spread across the two charities. And why is that wasteful? That's inefficient, economically inefficient, simply because in these scenarios in the lab is through duplication of fixed costs. One could do the production and the provision, and I'm not saying all the charities should give up to the biggest charity in the world so that they can capture scale concept. Not what I'm saying at all. It's not the recommendation. This happens, this is a prediction that donors are actually worried about fixed costs, and that they will actually spread their donations across the efficient and inefficient charities. They'll sort of average between the two because of this perception of risk. So there will be inefficiency. Right? Just because there's inefficiency through the duplication of fixed costs does not imply or suggest a charity should merge in order to get rid of that duplication, because there might be different varieties and other considerations to take into account. Our evidence, though, even more interesting, also suggests that this coordination induced inefficiency is more serious the bigger is the difference in fixed costs between the two options. So if we take two charities, that actually one has higher fixed costs and one has lower, but they're close. The gap between them is actually small. That results in less waste than if the gap is bigger. How can we show this on the diagram? Here's the results from the lab in terms of this. Here, what we see is that if I actually look at the potential performance of a £1 contribution, the best that contribution can do is generate £1 worth of output. It's a thinking that we can price things, right? So I can give a pound, a perfectly efficient outcome is one where that pound transforms into 1 pound worth of provision. In the lab, if there's actually two options and there's just a small gap between them, we don't get a pound, we only get 59 pence to the pound. So we're losing 41 pence on each pound contributed because of this donor sensitivities to the likelihood that other donors are going to make mistakes. If there's a large fixed cost gap, however, it falls quite, these look like small numbers possibly, but in large, where there's a lot of money involved, a lot of charities involved, they turn into huge numbers very quickly. The efficiency, the performance measure is only 50%.